NBC Radio News on the Hour, brought to you by 1968 Cream, the non-dairy creamer that's been tested for you. Now here is Dean Nell.
President Johnson and Senator Robert Kennedy have clashed again over the issue of Vietnam. Mr. Johnson told a group of young State Department workers headed for pacification duty in Vietnam that America's will not break in frustration and that peace with honor will be won. Senator Kennedy, in a speech to be delivered at Nashville, Tennessee later tonight, describes the president's call for unity as an attempt to suppress criticism of policies that are more dangerous to America than its enemy. Earlier, in a civil rights speech at the University of Alabama, an institution he forcibly integrated as Attorney General, Kennedy denounced the anarchy of black rioters and the repression of white demagogues. Kennedy's rival, Senator Eugene McCarthy, sought the support of young Democrats in Wisconsin. He told cheering college crowds in Racine and Janesville not to be deterred by charges that those against the war are appeasers. McCarthy said the essence of patriotism is to serve your country in truth. Governor Nelson Rockefeller's decision not to actively seek the presidency drew Republican praise for averting a divisive party fight and shocked disappointment from a few diehard supporters. Richard Nixon, the man who gains the most by Rockefeller's refusal to challenge him, is not yet claiming the GOP nomination. As he left New York to campaign in the Wisconsin primary, Nixon noted that Rockefeller had not excluded himself from a convention draft. Rockefeller has withdrawn from the Oregon primary. Barry Goldwater, the GOP nominee in 1964, congratulated Rockefeller for what Goldwater called a courageous and intelligent decision which will contribute immeasurably to a Republican victory. There was no White House reaction to the Rockefeller statement. News Secretary George Christian said the president did not hear it. More news after this from Crean.
It's hot here.
And humid. I'm sweating like a big man.
Hey, FNGs. Welcome to paradise. Just in time for the rainy season. If Charlie doesn't kill you, the weather will.
Asshole. Who the hell's Charlie anyway?
Have you been living in a cave? Filipino communists, Foxtrot Charlie, but people around here just call him Charlie.
Yeah, right. Let's find the fourth, shall we?
Lead the way.
FNG, welcome to Guam. Don't worry, your first mission will be an easy one. We're resupplying a fire support base. You'll be flying from the right seat. Here, the AC flies from the left seat because the downward visibility is better here through the chin bubble. Comes in handy when we gotta land in a tight LZ. And believe me, LZs around here are tighter than Jane Fonda's ass. Have you checked the pencil mark?
What pencil mark?
Man, you got a lot to learn. Sometimes Charlie sneaks in at night, pulls a pin from a hand grenade, and puts a rubber band on the handle to keep it from popping. He drops it in our fuel tank and walks away. The fuel dissolves into rubber in a few hours, boom goes the chopper. We lost two crews this way in February, so we leave a pencil mark on the fuel cap and fuselage, and if the two marks don't line up perfectly, you get the hell away from the ship and call the bomb squad. Don't worry, I already checked it. We're good to go. Start her up.
Roger that. Clear!
Company HQ. above 1,500 feet or right down treetop level. Everything in between is suicide. Charlie can be hiding anywhere, and a Huey at 500 feet is easier to hit than the broadside of a barn. So do us a favor and don't get everyone killed, alright? Let's climb up to 1,500 feet until I'm sure you have a good touch on the controls.
Roger, climbing to 1,500 feet.
next stop, Firebase Berlin. Check your map or you can go home in on them on Fox Mike. I don't know the frequency by heart.
rates. Fly!
about to be overrun. Popping smoke.
doctor now! Roger, I'm on the barber pole, flying at BNE, flying as fast as you'll go.
Let's get him out! Thank you, guys. Let me know your names for write-up.
Negative write-up. Just doing our jobs. Let's just get back home and make babies.
Roger. Good luck, boys.
Alright, let's get back to base. That was enough action for one day.
Roger. that soldier's stomach. Is every mission gonna be like this?
Keep your hopes up. It can get worse. Much worse. Better learn quick or you won't make it. Nice flying today, by the way. Now tune into the Armed Forces Radio on 117.2, will you?
Television is great.